And also, I prepared my speech. I threw out all the pages dealing with history. And just pick up a few things, because everything has already been covered by so many speakers. It's very unfortunate that Maine Mona has to be the last, and by so doing, he doesn't have anything else to say. But let me try. The ancient Akan tribe of West Africa has a saying. A quote, the ladder of death is not climbed by one person, unquote. In other words, it is a universal ladder which we all will climb at a time of God's choosing. Comrade Theo Ben has climbed this ladder, leaving behind vivid memories of his life well served, well lived, of the struggle well fought, of a race well run. In the history of mankind, countless individuals have stood up when the world cried out for champions of peace. These peacemakers dedicated their lives to fighting injustice, racism, and violent oppression. Oftentimes, they risked their own personal safety to support fellow human beings and to fight for equality using their unique skills of conflict resolution. Through Comrade Theo Bold Benjamin Dururo Burira, Namibia is proud to commemorate a deserving son who will be remembered in history as an influential peacemaker of his era. I am privileged to have walked the long journey with my brother, Theo Ben. A journey which began in 1958 when I arrived at Augustinium College at Okahandja as a young freshman with a thirst for knowledge and politics. Revolutionary fervor permeated the milieu at that time, following Ghana's independence on March 6, 1957. Africa became awashed in the optimistic spirit that black people could lead and pursue their own destiny. Comrade Theo Ben Gurira was a great mind, and instead of discussing people or events, he discussed ideas. Over the past several days, we have heard many recounts of the life of this son of Namibia. He has been lauded for his diplomatic acumen, his wit and shrewdness, his aptitude and calculating nature, his patience and ability to direct an argument. All of these speak of a man who had extraordinary cerebral capacity. He had no time for small-mindedness. I have been listening to all the speakers, and they mentioned all these qualities of this man. But no one also added that he didn't like lies. No one added that. I don't know why we didn't add that. I'll leave it there. Following our appointment by Comrade Mioma, Comrade Gurira remained in Philadelphia after we reached the United States. I cut some things out. He stayed there But during that time in America, it was the height of black power movement. It was the height of rebellion by black people. So we were luckily engulfed in that struggle, which actually helped us, shaped us, better revolutionaries to therefore understand what was happening in America that time. And indeed, I don't regret that we were there during that time. The diplomacy is the art of negotiation, used as a skill to manage communications outside the influence of the user. Comrade Gurirab was a shining exemplar of a top diplomat. The manner in which our comrade communicated the message of SWAPO to the international community following the Kasinga massacre was a testament of his tactfulness and skill. Earlier this week, Comrade Ohamba made that point eloquently clear. Comrade Gurirab was meticulous in research and hardworking, often staying up until midnight to draft documents. When we look at his legacy, we realize that all the years of blood, sweat, and tears paid off, not only for him personally, but for Namibia as a whole.
We salute you, comrade, we salute you. We salute you, comrade, we salute you. We salute you, comrade, we salute you. We salute you.